runway has two connotations for me. One's the catwalk, which refers to the theatre of the fashion industry, the sort of haiku theatre of the runway show, which I'm fascinated by. I find runway shows actually dismal, but also strangely exciting. And then also runway, as in the launch pad for an aircraft. Funnily enough, I've just thought of the third reason, which is the sort of runway of the exhibition space. So referring to a collection of costumes or clothes, and in many ways these are wearable sculptures or sculptures that you put yourself in and can try on. So the works in this show are actually very linked and part of a specific series. What I've tried to do with the lighting is create a theatrical mise-en-scene where the works are all suspended very specifically together. This is the tail boom from a gazelle that became a duck, a gazelle duck, supported by a helicopter blade that goes through the eye of the tail boom. I was thinking about Harold, the King of England, dying through an arrow being shot in his eye, and that being a moment where Britain kind of started to become France, oddly enough. It's a filmic moment laid down in the Bayeux Tapestry, but way before film, that, yeah, probably never happened, but it's a good story. This exhibition's been brewing for several years. Hendrik's been over to the studio and we've talked about what the exhibition might and could possibly be. There was an understanding and a trust about what could possibly happen. And it did happen in a really, really beautiful way, but that takes some confidence and sort of calmness, actually, to and trust. So, they're not things that you always get, not every day of the week.
Zij drukt het begrip beeldend kunstenaar wel heel erg ver in de marge. Het zijn onmiskenbaar beelden. Het is onmiskenbaar een vorm van beeldend theater. Het is kunst met ballen, letterlijk en figuurlijk. Er gaat een enorme vitaliteit vanuit en een kracht zit erin die ik ontzettend aantrekkelijk vind. Terwijl ik er steeds niet precies de vinger op kan leggen. Net als ik denk van nou ben ik er, ontgaat het me weer een beetje. Als je hier ook rondloopt, dan zie je dat ze in staat is geweest om dingen in die tentoonstelling bijeen te brengen waarvan je echt denkt van hoe is het haar gelukt? Hoe kom je nou aan een rotorblad van een militaire helikopter? En niet één, maar meerdere. En hoe krijg je zo'n tailfin van een grote, dure Harrier jet? Nou, dat zijn, laat ik zeggen, praktische problemen. Maar toch, als je dus zo begint, hè, het is niet de makkelijkste manier. Je kunt ook op een andere manier denken. En ja, daar hou ik van. Dat de kunstenaars die tot dat gaatje gaan.
Talking about the show earlier, I was saying to Hendrik that it's about a fear of invasion, but that's on many levels. There is that fear is very tangible at this point in time. It's been very intense for us in the UK, wondering what Brexit's going to mean. But actually, I think there are elements of that fear and sensation running through most of the continent as well. notions of conflict, notions of complex identity, but also notions of sexuality, notions of fear, fear of how we can and can't communicate. They all pervade the work. Various moments in this exhibition are collaborative works. I'd been asked to make a work with a London-based archive, Archive of Modern Conflict, which is a massive photographic library, really, of ephemeral photographic images that have something to do with conflict. But then the more I looked into the archive, the more I realised they didn't really have any photographs from here and now. And I thought it's interesting, this notion that conflict is elsewhere, but actually how is conflict motivated by us here and now? That's when I had the idea of photographing the City of London. It's like a sort of hermetic zone, and it has its own laws and its own culture. And it's all to do with the financial industry. And I asked Magnum photographer Paolo Pellegrin to photograph it as a conflict zone, so deploying his normal methodology. I asked him to follow the script of Heart of Darkness. Those photographs became the collaboration with the Archive of Modern Conflict, and I asked them to file them under Heart of Darkness. They then became the images that illustrated a new edition of Conrad's Heart of Darkness that I made in the form of a luxury magazine. And that magazine in turn became the protagonist in a film called Phantom. A drone phantom trying to make an image, trying to document this magazine, but in the process, blowing it and chasing it and actually finally destroying it. So it's sort of the whole story in the end becomes about the impossibility of the image. I got very into watching the Vietnam movies and realised that I couldn't make paintings from them at all. Saw myself as a painter at that time, and then I started writing the images out. And in the end, I realised I didn't want them to be a sort of single works of art. I wanted them to be something that was much more fluid. And that's why I got into making books. Things that, you know, don't necessarily aren't constrained by their singularity or self-importance or the gallery environment. At that point, the Vanity Press became an element. The Vanity Press is the moniker that I quite often work under. And publishing, direct publishing and also very experimental publishing. You could even say performative publishing is a big part of my practice. This is a rather masterful sketch of me here. That's my ISBN number. I'm published under my own name, Fiona Banner, in an attempt to make a sort of living portrait biography of myself, and then that kicked off into a whole other project relating to the ISBN number as a kind of titling system and a sort of poetic form at times itself. So a publication can be something incredibly ephemeral, and yet this is incredibly physical. I think we're highly fetishistic about sculptural objects and art. In a way, we're also highly fetishistic about military hardware for many reasons. We're immensely drawn to it, but at the same time repelled by it. You know, I'm not an issue-based artist. I'm not a political artist in that sense, but I don't see how you could even make a drawing of a figure without taking on the political dimension of that. If I make a work and it does exactly what I want it to do, I would be disappointed in that work. So I want it to be something else, for something else to happen. So I'm doing my best to gather the ingredients, but ultimately there's either humour in a work or not. And if there isn't, it doesn't have a trigger. So to go back to politics, you know, politics is not about humour. Whereas I feel that in art, that art is. This piece of airplane comes from a Jet Provost, which is a training plane. The colours are called Raspberry Ripple. So I already thought that's quite funny because Raspberry Ripple is like an ice cream. It's part of a whole body of work that toys with the idea of nose art. So nose art within the military is a kind of folk art that is drawn onto the side of the aircraft, often slightly sensational, sort of sexy or brutal, yet comic imagery. It's actually almost like a mascot. So I then have played with it on here. This is pinstripe, the fabric that's often used by people working in the financial sector, on a nose from a Harrier jump jet. I liked the nose because I thought it's both the most heroic moment of the aircraft because it's the bit that actually forges through the air, but it's also really absurd. And when you start looking at it, there's something endearing and almost comic about it. And then I put two together. Then they became like breasts or some kind of female armament, even. So there's always that playing with the sexuality of the objects as well. You know, what does it actually mean to cut a hole in a helicopter blade so you go up and stand in it? Really, what's interesting about that moment for me is that it sets up an idea of portraiture and mirroring, because actually you are never sticking your head through that hole for yourself. You're sticking it through because you want somebody else to look at you and find it funny. So it's making a game or a mise-en-scene out of that situation. I think what we want from art is to see ourselves, ultimately. And that's the scenario that the viewer walks into. The viewer is the person that enacts these works, that makes them happen. Hopefully there's a lightness and some humour to the work. So with the breathing bag, it's a plastic bag with air puffed into it. You know, it's saying a lot and it's also saying nothing. It's hot air.